So first we have a shoe. And this is from the brand Converse. So let's take a look at this shoe. The color is kind of like an off-white cream kind of color. It has some beige stitching here in this little design pattern with these little squares, so it definitely has some interest to it. It's not just plain. And these shoes are slightly worn a few times, but not too bad, so not too dirty. You can see the Converse All-Star logo on the back. And just notice the detail on the shoe. With the laces nice and tied up. See if there's anything worth noting. It has silver kind of hardware. And the stitches look like they are good quality. Manufactured up to standard. I'm seeing few marks from the streets, but nothing too bad. Check the inside. Okay, not too dirty. Seems look good. Let's just check the sole. Okay. Looks pretty nice. And it's maybe a small platform for some added height. Just check the laces. The laces are intact. Hidden in the shoe. Shoe looks okay. Let's move on to our next item. we have this small bag here. Can be for whatever you want it to be. So it is primarily black, and it has kind of a spooky, witchy design on it. Some things inside. So it has a few crescent moons, full moon here, a full moon here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 moons, with some kind of autumnal foliage around, some leaves, maybe a couple flowers, and just a simple texture. And it does have the same design on both sides. And at the top, it has a gold zipper. And to open it, you just pull on the little piece here, and then you can open the bag and see what's inside. Let's have a look. Okay, so personally, I use this bag to store some pens, pencils, things like that. Just take a look at the seams, you know, just make sure that everything's okay. With it. Let's see. Just check what's inside. Pen here with multiple colors. Looks like a pink highlighter. A blue kind of pen. Seems a bit broken. Black pen. And another black pen. Kind of a white pen. Sometimes it can get stuck. Okay. So that is the pouch. The pouch. The little pencil case. Just feel one final check here. We have this tube of body lotion. And this is from Victoria's Secret. It's called Coconut Milk and Rose. A calm scent. 24-hour moisture. Hydrating body lotion with shea butter and coconut oil. And it has a really pretty floral design. This like pink kind of rosy color. And it says on the back, feel calm with the scent of coconut milk and rose. And it does list all the ingredients here. And the text is just a little bit raised, so it has this nice texture on the back. And it has a gold cap here, and to use the lotion, just need to press with a finger on this part, right here, like this, and then the lotion will come out of this small hole, and to make it come out, you just need to squeeze the tube, like this, a little bit messy. Close it, you just press. Just put that down for a moment. And then you just rub the lotion in, like so. You can rub it on the backs of your hands, in between your fingers. Piece that has been sealed together just here. Just sealed together here. It looks like a fairly strong seal. And the cap is just screwed on there with a pretty standard screwing type mechanism. Okay. No sharp edges. No sharp edges. Looks pretty good. Let's just feel how much is left in there. Doesn't seem like a lot has been used. Do have a decent amount of lotion left in here, and a little bit goes a long way, so this should last for a decent amount of time, unless you're drowning your entire body in it. We have just a little small pouch. This small pouch of treasure. This pouch has multiple colors in it. You can see a bit of orange. Let's take a look. Some orange, red, green, blue. And it has some gold kind of shimmer in it. Maybe a bit of pink. A bit of pink. Some brown, perhaps. The pattern is about the same on both sides. And it's just closed here with this little string. So, since this string is kind of woven through the fabric, when it's pulled, the back is closed, and you can just open it up by squeezing the fabric and pulling it apart, just like this. And just taking your fingers in there and just loosening that up so you can open the bag. And inside, looks like we just have a few crystals. Some other little ones. This one here. And this one here. This is just a clear quartz. Just put those back. Just feel around. You can put anything you want into a bag like this. It is especially good for small objects. So, if you want to close the bag, you just pull on the two strings here, and it will cinch the fabric back together. Just like that. It's a pretty soft fabric. It looks like it could be homemade. With just some white string here, with two knots, one on either side, to keep the string fastened together. Okay. Next, we have this bag here. This is, I suppose, technically classified as a fanny pack. Just in a basic black color. It has two zippers in the front. And nothing on the back, just a nice kind of stretchy elastic type strap here to go around the body, and a little clasp here so that you can open and close it. Open and close it. So if you want to open it, there is a small button here that you can press to release the clip, just like that, and then you can wrap it around your waist, and you can just put the clip, just align it back into the slot there, and just push, and it will clip back. If you would like to adjust it, you can simply use this device here, feed the strap through, and just make it bigger or smaller. it is sewn to either side of the main bag here. So this could be used for running, perhaps, to keep your belongings with you if you don't have any pockets, since it is rather flat. At least that's what I got it for. Let's go ahead and just have a look on the outside before we check the pockets. And just checking the stitching. Looks okay. Maybe a little bit hard to see. And two zippers. Feel the back. You can feel a few items in there. I'm just gonna open this top one up by pulling on the little zipper tab. Looks like inside this pouch we have a pack of gum. This is Orbit Sweet Mint Gum. One of my favorites. You can just open up gum pouch. Looks like we have full stock here. Full stock of gum. This is gum that I picked up while traveling last year, and I haven't wanted to use it yet. So, just put the little tab back in. Okay. Front pocket. Just feel around. We have two things in here. We have what looks like to be a chapstick. This is cool mint flavored chapstick. This goes on your lips. And this is a sanitizing gel to cleanse your hands. The essentials to stay fresh. Just put those back into the bag here. Okay. Seems like with this bag, you can only really store small, kind of flat items. Would be good to put a phone in there though. So that is the fanny pack. Okay, moving on to our last item for today. This is a book. With this, you look at the pages and you use your mind and your brain to read the words, and your eyes look at the pages and read. This is a poetry book, so it is compiled of lots of short texts in the form of poetry. Many pages here you can have a look at. This book in particular is called Pillow Thoughts. It has a nice black cover with what looks like to be a jellyfish. Look like there are any pictures in this book, maybe a couple at the start of a new chapter. Just words on white pages. So when you feel like reading a book, just pick it up. It depends if you've started the book ready, if you've already made some progress, but you just go to the page that you want to start reading. You just flick through like this, just flick through until you find your desired page. You can hold the book open with one hand like this and look at the book and read from left to right, if you're reading in English, left to right, word by word, piecing together the meaning and your interpretation of the words. Since reading is primarily related to words, your imagination plays a large part in how you interpret words, the story, and it can be a relaxing experience, an entertaining experience, a educational experience, and that can come down to the type of book that you're reading, the genre, topic. You understand? Good. So this book looks slightly used, but nothing too bad. Used books tend to have a lot of character because you might not be sure who read the book before you. They tend to last a pretty long time if taken care of correctly. This book has a relatively soft cover, meaning that the front part is not too firm, but some books can be hard covered, but not this one. Okay. So, that last object for today, for this very nonsensical video. I hope that you enjoyed seeing and learning about all of these items. Thank you so much for being here, and I'll see you very soon. Next time, sleep tight. Good night.